Alright, so Caribena versicolor, everything about this girl and about this species in general, coming right up. And also, you know, we have one baby of hers right here, also an update on that. But before all of that, let me just get this out of the picture. Yeah, it is done. I'm a married man now, and you can maybe hear from my voice it is a bit rougher than usual. Thank you for all the nice wishes on the Instagram. And since I posted that picture with me and my wife with the ring, me and my wife, so weird to hear, with me and Maya, that is now the most liked picture on the Dark Den Instagram page. What the hell, guys? I thought that you are there because of the spiders and yeah. Now, about this girl. And just as I tried to open this enclosure, the door system broke in multiple ways. Okay, excellent. Great start of the video. But she is somewhere in her tunnel. Maybe we can see her. Yeah, that's the booty, you see. You know, when she had an exec, she was actually living behind the background. But since then, since I pulled the exec, she moved in front and actually made a nice web tunnel going like this, you see. This is something that Avicularia species usually do. And even though she's not Avicularia, she's Caribena. She used to be an Avicularia genus. And she's also really similar, so they like to do those tunnels on top of the enclosure. So in this video, we are going back to the beginnings. We are going back when I got her, and I will chronologically show you all the feeding clips, all the other clips, rehouses, and everything that I have recorded about her. And also, what is really cool about these species in general is when they are slings, they look different from when they are adults. So as they are growing, they are changing their appearance, and that is something really cool to observe. Now we have a baby here that I'm going to show you, and you will immediately see that that baby looks completely different than her. You see how it is dark, but under the bright light it is kind of bluish greenish tint. You see that the abdomen is kind of shiny. Let me just zoom in on that. Yeah, now you can see it well. This is how the sling looks. And then slowly, but surely, that appearance transitions into something purplish, reddish. You can't really see it from here, but don't worry, I have a ton of recordings that I'm going to show you. But in order to do that, we need to teleport back into the old Dark Den, because over there on the computer, I have all the recordings, all the footage that we are going to, that we will go through. So yeah,
teleport and also a time jump. You can hear that my voice is now a bit more normal because it is now next day after the previous recording. So where are we? I actually have all the dates written in this notebook about the information in regards to that girl. So I got her on Terra Plaza, and that was in October of 2015, and the price was only €5. The earliest recording of her is this picture. You see, this is as soon as I got her, so she was a bit bigger than her baby now. So I would assume that she was like second or maybe third molt, most likely second, but I'm not 100% sure. So that means that she's now like 5 years old, a bit more, because she was already sling of certain age. And this is actually the first recording of her. I was using my old cell phone to record this, and I actually put macro lens to get this kind of bad close-up shots, but it is the earliest video recording of her that I have. But it is showcasing her shiny color really good, and you can see it really well. Then after that, the next recording is an actual rehouse, and this was actually recorded in a kind of first video where I used two cameras over there. So that was like a transition video of me recording a video on some random spot in my apartment to actually dedicating, having like a fixed shot that I'm developing, you know. So that is a cool fact. And now you can see that she was a bit bigger here. She outgrew her cup, you see, and I was forced to rehouse her in something bigger. And you can kind of see that she's still greenish bluish, but her abdomen is really, that pattern on the abdomen is really pronounced, because she is now of course bigger, but she basically looks still just like a sling. Her coloration is still just like her baby, and they look amazing as slings. So as I was trying to rehouse her, You see that I was kind of confused in that shot because she actually pooped me. You see this is actually a tarantula poop, and that was the first time that a tarantula pooped on me, but not the last time. She also pooped in some other video while I was handling her. And this is recorded a few days later after that rehouse. She already made a web. She webbed up those cork barks and just settled up nicely. And this is the first feeding clip with her. Bam! Yeah, she got it. Now looking back to it, I'm really surprised that I didn't record her earlier, but I think that main reason is I still didn't had a proper camera. I was using my cell phone to record, and that cell phone wasn't really capable of focusing at close distance. So small slings, the recordings of them weren't really good enough, so that was probably the main reason why I didn't record her earlier. And this is when she molted. I pulled the molt and tried to save her. I also fed her, and this is also a decent clip. And just check out that legs. Ah, oh, that color, it was so beautiful. But unfortunately, I wasn't able to sex her because the molt was destroyed too much, so it wasn't possible. So next feeding clip, and she was kinda twitchy, as you can see. Really, really hungry. And she was showing off her booty a little bit. Now, this is another time she molted, and I'm not really sure if I was able to sex her this time or not, but I fed her. Let's just wait for that to happen. Yeah, slowly creeping. Now, if you look at her abdomen, you see that she is slowly changing her appearance. She's slowly getting those red hairs, and now we have a slow grab. Yeah, there it is. Now you can see it really well. Her carapace is actually getting super shiny, and her abdomen is reddish, so this was a step to changing her appearance. And I have some other dates. Yeah, that recording was recorded in May of 2017. So yeah, this is when she started changing her appearance. And this is one molt later, you see she completely changed. Oh, and that was a nice feeding clip, but you see that her appearance is completely changed. Her legs are reddish, her carapace is more greenish than bluish, and she just overall looks like an adult tarantula. I'm not really sure if they got that coloration once they are adult or not, but this was recorded in September of 2017. So yeah, around 2 years to get an adult coloration. A beautiful, beautiful coloration, and you see, we have a happy dance. This was actually a first recorded happy dance with her. Now, I think that this was recorded one molt after those previous feeding clips, and you can see that she is a bit more fuzzier than she used to be. So with time, she was getting that extra fuzziness, a beautiful fuzziness, and still feisty, still super fast to grab roaches. And all of that led us into a rehouse of her, into her current enclosure. You see, this is, it's looking a bit better than it is looking currently. And also, if I remember correctly, I actually attempted to handle her. Yeah, she just climbed on my hand. And this was the second time that she kinda pooped while I was holding her. Yeah, that will happen in just a sec. Yeah, there it is. Just pip. And that was immediately followed by this random jump, you see. It was like, what the hell? What are you doing? But eventually, after a bit of strolling around the perimeter on the doors and in all directions, I managed to get her in the enclosure. And just look how green it was. Now everything is, all plants are dead because she webbed across them, so they just died off, unfortunately. But after that, I think that, yeah, I've tried to feed her, and yeah, she was into that. No, I'm saying it wrong. This was after she was living in that enclosure for a while, because you can see behind there is some webbing on the bromeliad. This is when she started to destroy the bromeliad. But happy dance. Yeah, distract us from the destruction of the plants with a happy dance. Thank you. More feeding clips, this time with a cricket. This was actually her first cricket, I believe. And now with one hissing roach. Yeah, you see, plants are still green here, but you will see slowly that will transition into something different. Yeah, I'm actually showing off the plants, you see. The enclosure was so nice. Oh, this clip, this was making of booty calendar, tarantula booty calendar. I grabbed the macro lens and got some awesome shots of her booty. Yeah, and also the spinnerets, they're so sweet. Now one worm feeding, first one of those. She loved every food that I ever offered to her. She never refused anything. And now this was sexy time, you see. That happened in January of this year. I was a bit worried at start because I wasn't sure if she's big enough, because I have seen some females that are significantly bigger than her. So that worried me a bit, but there wasn't any problem with this sexy time. She just let male do whatever he wants, and he took that opportunity for some sweet time. You see, she let him get away all nice and calmly, which was awesome. And then how many months later? Just 3 months later, I spotted an exec. Yeah, she was actually behind the background, you see, holding an exec. And in May I actually pulled that exec. She didn't really want to let it go that easily, but eventually I managed to steal it, and I quickly offered her male dubia in exchange, which she didn't refuse. She was actually quite hungry, but the result was a successful exec, you see. There were some eggs with legs, and overall I was super hyped with that, because you see, this looks awesome, right? Made me think that in the future we will have a ton of Caribena versicolor babies. At least that was what I thought. Then on the 21st of May, majority of them, as you can see, molted in their first instar. They were no longer eggs with legs, but they actually started to kinda look like a spider, although not quite. Yeah, there they are. And everything seemed in order. I was really happy how they were developing. You see, they eventually started to darken up with me, which means that they will molt, and I was looking forward to them molting, because after that, you know, we will get a ton of awesome small Caribena versicolor babies that look amazing. But then, you know what happened, you know the tragedy. As they were darkening up, every day I would found a couple of dead sling inside, and I didn't really know what was happening. I didn't know what to do, so I was asking friends that had some experience with avicularia babies, because even though they are Caribena, they are still similar tarantulas. And the advice was to increase humidity and temperature, which I did, but unfortunately 2 or 3 weeks later, all of them eventually died off. Just one individual actually molted and became a proper tarantula, proper Caribena versicolor sling. You see, this is that one, the one that I showed you at the start of this video, which was really sad. And I'm still not sure why that happened, because so far, in the same way, in the same cup, I managed to raise Brahim Tiltocatl albopilosum babies, Tiltocatl vagans babies, also the Hysterocrates gigas babies. I raised them up the same way. So there are two possibilities. Either the Caribena versicolor babies are far more fragile than those species and need some extra care, a bit different from what I provided, or there was something internally wrong with them. But what exactly is, I don't know, and I probably never will. And we are finishing off with the last clip, which was another feeding clip, just like previous clip, some mature male adult dubia. Yeah. And that's it. Those are all the clips, all the recordings that I have of my girl. I hope that you like seeing her grow from tiny sling into an adult tarantula that actually became a mother of brief. I mean, she is still mother because she have one baby left. So technically she is still a mother with a baby. But regardless, if you like the video, make sure to thumbs up and comment something. If you want to support this channel even more, there's a Patreon page. If you're new to this channel, make sure to subscribe. Also, one quick information. I'm going on a vacation on the coastal area of Croatia, and I will try to do a nature adventure video. So maybe soon you can expect that. I'm not promising that 100%, but there's a chance. So bye.